this application, we have a text box which is disabled. Assume that it is going to be dynamic in nature, sometimes it is going to be enabled and sometimes it is going to be disabled. Now, whenever it is enabled, we have to type something on that. And if it's disabled, then we have to skip the execution. Now, to do that, obviously, we have to learn the conditional statement. Here, by default, the value is false. So, as of now, our text box is disabled. And here, I'm going to check if it's going to be true. Now, if it's true, then I will say, okay, do something on that text box, like type something or whatever the actions which is applicable in the input box. Now, here we are logging this as completed so that we will know, okay, our test case is completed. But if you have noticed, we didn't get the value type something. Now, I'm able to get the value type something because the statement is true now. So the learning here is whenever the statement of if condition is true, then only we will get the output. If the value is going to be false, obviously it is not going to run, right? Because the if condition is not satisfied. So here I'm going to say else, because we know that obviously we should also skip the execution, right? So here I'm going to say skip. The logic and syntax is very simple here. If in if condition, if the condition is matches, it is going to execute that part, or else it is going to the else part. Now assume that we are going to do a multiple cross browser testing, that is nothing but running our test case in multiple browsers. So here I'm going to say a few browsers name like Chrome, Edge, Firefox. Okay, so the default value is Firefox. Now I'm going to check for Chrome. So if the value is Chrome, then run in Chrome, or else I'm going to say else if the browser is going to be Firefox, then execute in Firefox. So we got the answer as run in Firefox, right? Now also I'm going to check for Edge browser. Now here I'm going to say console.log and run in Edge. Now user is opting for Opera, but if you have noticed, we didn't get any output, right? The reason is none of the if condition is satisfied because we are writing if else if. So if that matches, then it will do, right? But none has been matched, so it is going to in the else part. So it is so obvious, whenever you are going to use multiple condition, multiple if condition, then always recommended to use else, so that user will know that, okay, something has been wrong, I should select some other browser, right? Now if you see that in the console we got Opera is not available, so based on this user is going to select. Now let us understand how this really works. So here we have a browser which has been assigned to Opera. Now it will go and check the first if condition. The value is matched? No. So it is going to do the next condition, right? Similarly, it will go on, it will keep on going until any matching condition. If none of the condition has been matched, then it is going to go inside the else part. But this is going to take much computation time, right? So obviously we have a better way, which is nothing but switch. In switch statement, we have to pass a key as a parameter, and the key is nothing but our browser. Right now the browser variable has some values. Now based on the values, we are going to write a cases here. If you have noticed, in if we used to write browser equals to Firefox, right? Similarly, same action, but here instead of condition we have to write the cases. So whenever the case is going to be matched, then that case is going to execute. Now in if condition, it is going to check for each and every condition. If the condition satisfied, then it is going to run. Whereas in switch, based on the key value, it is going to execute. For example, here we have Edge, so the case of Edge has been executed. Now if I change the value to Chrome, then the first case, that is Chrome, is going to execute. Now also, if you have noticed, there is a something new keyword called break, right? Now let me comment that break and let's see what happens. So as soon as I comment, it is going to execute the next case as well, and respectively it is going to do for the other cases as well. That means whenever you are going to use the switch statement, you have to use either the break or the return keyword, or else it is going to keep on running for the next cases as well. Now consider that user is going to opt for Opera browser. Okay, so here browser equal to Opera. Now we didn't get any output because obviously none of the case has been matched. So it is obvious that we have to say the user, okay, you have chosen something else, so you have to choose the appropriate one. So here within the default statement, I'm going to say browser is not available. That means whenever the any of the cases are not going to match, then default is going to execute. Now, default is not mandatory, but obviously it can be used. That is recommended as well. I'm going to declare an array with some values, and also I'm going to use the property length to identify how many values are there. Consider that this is going to be your number of users, where you are going to write a test case and you are going to run for multiple users. So for that, obviously I have to go with the for here. So here I'm going to say for, and within the bracket, let I equal to 0, that is our starting position. And here I'm going to say, based on the number of users, iterate till that. And also I'm going to say, I'm going to increment one at a time. So one user will execute one at a time, right? Now here I'm going to log the fruits value as of now. So we are able to get the value as apple, mango, grape, cherry, banana, and pineapple, right? This is fine. But how does it really works? Okay, so here we have a let I equal to 0, that is my starting position, and then I have I lesser than length, that is my conditional statement. And then I have this I plus plus, which is nothing but either I can do the increment or the decrement. So based on that, the for loop is going to work. Now we already know that in JavaScript, obviously there are multiple ways to do that, right? So I'm going to show you one more for, which is nothing but for off. Okay, so whenever you have an object, you can use the for off here. Now the advantage of using for off is you no need to worry about the starting and the ending position. Now instead of object, I'm going to pass my fruits, because we know that array is of type object, right? Now here the word iterator is not a keyword, it is just a word, it can be anything. Okay, so we are creating a local variable, that's it. I'm going to log the iterator. Okay, so here it is going to give me all the values. The only major difference is here you no need to worry about the starting and the ending position. So based on the object type, it is going to assume itself, and then it is going to run for the number of data we have. Next, consider that we have a object data type, right? So to iterate over an object data type, we are going to use the for in. The syntax is going to be very same as for off, just instead of off, you have to make it as in. And here I'm going to log the browsers, and within the square bracket, I have to pass the iterator, because in the browsers object, we have multiple values, right? So each and every curly braces is a value, right? So I'm going to pick one value at a time. Now if I log, if you check the log, it says that name Chrome version 80 and name Firefox and version 75. So this is how you can also log your object data type. But in the array video, we also have seen what is the use of for each, right? Now for in is not recommended to use, so I will leave a link in the description. So if you want to read more, you can go and check that.